What's up YouTube, this is Jason Undisputed back here again, this time with another Let's Review video. And today we have really surprising news today because we are getting Light and Darkness Dragon support in the main booster set Infinite Forbidden box set. So yeah, very surprising to see a Light and Darkness Dragon support. So if you don't know what Light and Darkness Dragon support are, it's basically the manga's cuts of Chess Princeton or Manjome Thunder, whatever you want to call him. But yeah, I'm really surprised they decided to boost Light and Darkness Dragon, because it's been so long since a Light and Darkness Dragon got support. So yeah, very surprising to see Light and Darkness Dragon getting support. But yeah, let's scroll down and let's see what we have here. As you can see here, I am now a YGO organization, and look at that. Become the Lord of Light and Darkness with Chess manga support. So yeah, Chess, if you didn't know, Chess Princeton is the rival of Jaden Yuki. So basically, he the Arm Dragon guy. So yeah, in the manga, he was playing a different deck instead of Arm Dragon or XYZ Dragon Cannon. So yeah, let's just see what we have here. Alright, so we have, as you can see here, the manga with Light and Darkness Dragon over here. And then this is Dark End Dragon, this is Light End Dragon. So but funny enough, these two cards in the actual card game are Synchro Monsters, which didn't make sense in the past because Chess Princeton is from GX. So it didn't make sense for them to make them a Synchro, but now I'm guessing they are gonna give us the actual Light and Darkness Dragon from the manga. So let's see what we have here. So you see, over here, you can see here, Dark End Dragon, Light End Dragon, Synchro Monsters. Then Light and Darkness Dragon is a few, it's an effect monster. So yeah, let's see here. So, Chess Manga's Ace Remade. Look at that art, man. Look at that. Can you guys see it properly? Oh, looks so damn nice. Look at that, a Light and Darkness Dragon fusion right off the bat. So yeah, let's see here, we have Light and Darkness Dragon Lord. So it's a level 10 Light Dragon fusion effect monster. Attack 3400, defense 3000. Fusion material is 1 level 8 Light Dragon monster plus 1 level 8 Dark Dragon monster. Very simple material. So, must be fusion summoned. First effect, while face up on the field, this card is also Dark attribute, same as the OG Light and Darkness Dragon. Second effect, once per turn, once per chain, when a spell or trap or monster effect is activated, quick effect, you can lose, this card loses exactly 1000 attack and defense, and if it does, negate the activation. Okay, just like the old Light and Darkness Dragon, but instead of losing 500, it loses 1000. That's more than Light and Darkness Dragon. And the second effect, it's mandatory, so you cannot choose what you want to negate. You have to negate whatever is being activated at that time. So if you have this card on your field and your opponent activates 3 effects, he's losing 3000, which makes him 0 defense and 400 attack, but you are negating 3 things that your opponent activates, which is pretty good. I'd say it's pretty good, but it does negate your stuff as well, so be careful when using this card. Last effect, if this card is destroyed by your opponent, you can target one dragon monster in your graveyard, special summon it. Okay, that's a pretty good floating effect. It dies, it summons out any dragon, but I would have preferred it to have the effect to summon a dragon monster in your graveyard, ignoring summoning conditions so that you can summon any dragon you want. Because if I'm not wrong, Light and Darkness Dragon cannot be special summoned, which sucks. So yeah, I wish it had an effect so you can summon out your Light and Darkness Dragon so you can negate even more stuff on your opponent's field during your opponent's turn. But yeah, I guess they thought it was too broken, so yeah, they decided to give effect like this. But yeah, never mind. It's quite a nice card. Having 3 negates during your opponent's turn is actually pretty good. So yeah, let's move on. Then we have Light Sublimation Dragon. Look at that, love that art, man. I love it. A Light Dragon, Light End Dragon effect monster. That's pretty cool. So Light End Dragon Sublimation Dragon, level 8, 2600 attack 2100 defense. You can only use the first, second, and third effect of this card name each once per turn. So first effect, you can banish one level 8 Dark Dragon monster from your extra deck. Special summon this card from your hand. Also, you cannot special summon for the rest of the turn except Dragon monsters. That's a quite of a very costly lock there. You can only summon dragons after you summon him. Not from the extra deck though. So every time you summon this card, you are locked to summoning dragons only. Not really much of a problem, but yeah, it will hurt some of the decks that you might want to play it into. Second effect, during your main phase, you can fusion summon one fusion monster from your extra deck using monsters in your hand or field as material. Third effect, when your opponent's monster declares an attack, you can make this card lose exactly 500 attack or defense. And if it does, that opponent's monster loses 1500 attack. So yeah, that's a pretty good card. So once your fusion monster dies, you can summon this card out. And then whenever your opponent declares an attack, you can literally make this card loses 500 attack, and then that monster will lose 1500 attack permanently, which is pretty good. But sadly, it's only once per turn. So yeah, you can only make your opponent monster lose an attack once per turn. It's pretty sad, but yeah, not too bad. Yeah, that was pretty good. I mean, it's a free monster anyway. You can just banish one level 8 dragon monster from your extra deck and just spend some of this card. It's pretty good. And there are plenty of level 8 dragon monsters from your extra deck. In fact, both of the synchros are level 8, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, they are. So you can just banish them and spend some of them. Yeah, it's pretty good. Pretty interesting card. Let's move on. So we have Dark and Evaporation Dragon. Let me just look at the arts first. Whoa! I love this art. This art is amazing. I always prefer Dark End Dragon to Light End Dragon. Because Light End Dragon looks so cool. Like a demonic dragon, man. Like, it reminds me of Azidahaka in Body Fight. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Okay, Dark End Evaporation Dragon. Level 8, 2600 and 2100 defense. Wait, is it level 8? Is it? Oh, it is level 8. Okay, makes sense. Then, you can only use the first and second effect of this card name each once per turn, same as the Light End Dragon one. You can banish one level 8 dragon monster from your extra deck, spend summon this card from your hand. Also, you cannot spend summon for the rest of this turn except dragon monster, same as the Light End Dragon's first effect. Then second effect, you can activate one of these effects. Fusion summon one fusion monster from your extra deck using monsters from your hand or field as material. Second effect, target one other attack position monster. This card loses exactly 500 attack and defense, and if it does, destroy that target. Okay, so yeah, a little bit better than Light End Dragon, but this card only works during your turn. It's pretty sad. While Light End Dragon losing attack is, you can use it during your opponent's turn. So yeah, this card, I would say this card is better than Light End because this card can pop a card. Yeah, but it targets, so yeah, that's pretty good. Nah, very nice. The artwork is just amazing. I love the artwork. Okay, then we have a Wind Dragon monster. It's Knight Armed Dragon. Okay, so we have an Armed Dragon support. Like, I mean, it's chest, you know. You're definitely giving him an Armed Dragon support. Let me look at the artwork, man. It looks, pretty good. Like an American dragon wearing armor. That's pretty cool. I like that. Pretty nice. Then level 3 Wind Dragon effect monster, attack 1400, defense 1900. You can only use the first, second, and third effect of this card name each once per turn. If you spend summon a level 5 or higher dragon monster, you can spend summon this card from your hand. That's pretty good. Then, if this card is spend summon, you can make its attribute and level become one of your banished dragon monsters. Ooh, that's pretty good. Then the last effect is, if this card is sent to the graveyard, you can target one dragon monster you control. It gains 1000 attack. Neither player can activate cards or effects in response to this effect's activation. That's pretty interesting. So the last effect is not negatable. Interesting. And then, in special summon, you can make him become one of your banished dragon monster's level. If you banish a level 8 dragon monster, you can make him become level 8. But pretty good. Very interesting. Right. Now we have a quick play spell for Light and Darkness Dragon. Look at that. Let me see the art. The art is just amazing. So we have, this side is the dark and this side is the light. Look at that quick play spell. Looks amazing. Let me see what is the effect. So we have Dragon's Glory of Light and Dark. Quick play spell. Activate one of these effects, but you can only use each effect of this card name once per turn. First effect, shuffle one level 8 dragon monster from your hand into the deck, and if you do, add one level 8 dragon monster with a different attribute from your deck to your hand. Pretty interesting. That's pretty good. Then target one dragon monster you control, it gains attack equal to its level times 200. Then it's the last effect. When a card or effect is activated that targets a dragon monster you control, negate that effect. Oh, that's pretty good. So it's quite generic actually. You can actually splash it in a lot of dragon decks, but I guessing the most decks you will actually splash this in is actually his own deck and maybe Chaos Dragons, because Chaos Dragons love to banish stuff, right? So yeah, that's actually pretty good. That's actually a pretty good card right over here. Sadly, this effect is not a graveyard effect. I would prefer it if it was a graveyard effect, so it make it like a Return of the Dragon Lords, but yeah, sadly it's not. But yeah, it's a pretty interesting card. The first effect though is actually pretty good. Shuffle one level 8 Dragon Monster from your hand to the deck, then if you do add a level 8 Dragon Monster with a different attribute from the deck to your hand. That next effect is really, really good. Alright, so yeah, that's all. Oh, look at that QSR, man. That is sick. Wow. Konami really getting a lot of good dragon support this year, really, because it makes sense because this year is the year of the dragon, right? So yeah, they're giving us a lot of dragon support. And look at that QSR, looks damn nice. I would love it. I would love to have a copy of this. So yeah, that is the Chess Princeton manga support, guys. Hope you guys enjoy. What do you guys think? Do you think the support is good? Do you think it's bad? I find it pretty good. The fusion monster, it's actually pretty good. It's quite splashable in a lot of decks, dragon decks especially. You might run it. You might want to run this cards in like Dragon Links or Chaos decks, you know. But Chaos decks do have non-dragon, so you might be able to make a pure Dragon Chaos deck. I don't know if that's possible, but yeah, let's see how it goes. Most probably it's possible. But yeah, this card's looking to be really, really good. And Infinite Forbidden looks to be a very interesting pack right here. I was actually planning to get just one box and that's it. But thanks to this support, I might be getting more boxes now, because I really do want these cards, man. Especially the fusion. Fusion looks just beautiful, man. Yeah, and that's my review for this Princeton cards, manga cards, guys. Hope you guys enjoy. If you do like what you see, please do leave a like, subscribe to my channel, and stay tuned for more. If you didn't know, guys, I have social media right now. You can follow me in the links in the description box down below. So yeah, that's all for today, guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. This is Jason Undisputed, signing off.